In this video, we'll be solving a question from the Chinese Math Olympiad. Find all possible integer solutions of the equation 2x squared plus y squared minus 2xy minus 4x minus 30 equals 0. Now let's see how to solve one equation for two variables. First, let's reorganize the left-hand side. We're going to write this term first. Y squared, then minus 2xy, then plus 2x squared minus 4x minus 30, then equals 0. So if we group these three together, now we can treat this equation as a quadratic equation in y. So then this is a b, then this is a c. So now use quadratic formula to solve for y. Then y equals negative times negative 2x, then plus minus, then the square root here, negative 2x squared minus 4 times this part, 2x squared minus 4x minus 30, then all divided by 2. Simplify. And here 2x plus minus, here 2 times the square root, then negative x squared, then plus 4x plus 30, then all divided by 2. Continue to simplify by cancel out the common factor, then equals x plus minus the square root. Then for the part under the square root, we are going to reorganize it. First, let's write 30. Then combine these two by taking out the negative sign. Then minus x squared minus 4x. Next, we want to form a complete square including these two terms. So then here we need a plus 4. Then we need a minus 4. Then minus 4, then combine with the negative, so then here is plus 4. So now we have the solution for y. Then y equals x plus or minus. Combine these two together, that's 34. Then these three terms form a complete square, which is x minus 2. Then squared. So now let's label this one as equation 1. Since y is a positive integer, so that means this part, the part under the square root, 34 minus x minus 2 squared must be a perfect squared. So now let's narrow down the range of x. For what x values, the part under the square root is a perfect square. First, let's see. Since the part under the square root must be bigger than or equal to 0, so that means first, 34 minus x minus 2 squared is bigger than or equal to 0. So that means x minus 2 squared is less than or equal to 34. Because x is a positive integer, so that means for x minus 2, because 6 squared is 36, so that means x minus 2 must be less than 6. That means less than or equal to 5. So that means x less than or equal to 7. So now we just narrow down the range of x. So now let's check the values of x one by one. For what x values, the part under the square root is a perfect square. So now let's check one by one. Okay, for x equals 1, 2, up to 7. Then we find only one only when x equals 5. Then the part under the square root 34 minus x minus 2 squared, then equals, here is a 25, then is a complete square. And also when x equals 7, then the part under the square root 34 minus x minus 2 squared equals 9, which is 3 squared is a perfect square. So now we figure out the x values, 5 and 7. So now we need to figure out the y values. So then take these two x values and plug into the here in equation 1. So now let's see if x equals 5. So let's see the first case. So if x equals 5, so then plug into equation 1. Then y equals 5 plus or minus here 25, square root of 25, then just 5 plus or minus 5, just equals 10 or 0. Since y is a positive integer, so y cannot be 0, so that means y just equals 10. So now we have the first set of the solution, which is x equals 5, y equals 10. Then x equals 5 and y equals 10. This is the first set of the solution. Now let's see the second case, when x equals 7. Here, if x equals 7, so then plug into the equation 1, then y equals 7 plus or minus the square root of 9, and here plus or minus 3, then equals 10 or equals 4. So now we have the solution. So that means x equals 7. So x equals 7, then y equals 10. Or the second case. So x equals 7, then y equals 4. So now let's combine these two solutions with the solution here. So now we have the solutions of the equation, which is one for x or y. First one is when x equals 7, then first when x equals 5, then y equals 10. Then the second one is when x equals 7, then y equals 10. The third one is when x equals 7, y equals 4. So then we have three positive integer solutions of the equation. Thanks for watching.